What's up everybody, welcome to the first part of making the SKIBIKE. In this part I will cover the basics of how I construct the steel base and test how much force it could handle. So let's start with the bottom part of our model. I firstly extrude a rectangle and drill 4 6mm holes on both sides. A 0.5mm fillet is applied on the corners and the bottom part is complete. Now let's make the sides. I drew a 60.30 rectangle and extruded it for 12cm with thin feature. Then I make two cuts on both sides, the first one is 60 degrees and the second one is 30. After that I cut a hole through entire body that will serve as our shaft for the bike. A few fillets and the sides are complete. Last two parts we need to make are two steel pipes, each of them extruded exactly to a specific length. So now when we have our parts, we can make an assembly and this is where the fun begins. I try to use as less mates as possible, and another tip here for positioning the pipe exactly in the middle of the base is to use an advanced mate called width. Let's save the first one and quickly make the second with a shorter pipe. So after finishing making the assemblies, we can now test how much of a stress could handle our assembly. So click on tap simulation and choose static study. I already applied the material to be steel, so things left to do is to add a fixed geometry at the bottom and apply the force of 1000 newtons, which is around 100 kilos, in the downwards position through the pipe. After that, create a mesh as fine as your computer could handle and click on run. The model that we can see now is the deformed result, and we can see with the red color where the maximum stress is. We could add a fillet on the corners to make the model even stronger, but the maximum stress is way lower than the actual stress needed to break the construction. Let's find out how much force could handle the model before it broke. 5000 newtons is still acceptable force, but what if you, for example, apply 2 tons of force? Now the situation is a bit different. We can see the maximum stress the material could handle is the red zone, so the construction is gonna pretty much collapse. So now, just for fun, I mount our bases to the actual bike and a pair of skis to see how it's going to look like when I finish it. The bases and a few other parts are going to be painted in yellow, otherwise the bike frame and some other parts are going to be black. And we are finished! Thank you all for watching this video. If you enjoyed that one, please make sure to watch other parts as well, and don't forget to hit that subscribe button to stay on track. Next video I'll cut, weld and mount the skis on the base, so stay tuned because this is going to be epic. Again.